The Chameleon-Sage image. Kind of national scale reusable cyber infrastructure to enable AI at the edge. Cool things like wildfire detection, vehicle tracking, snowflake classification, and social distancing detection will be made available at the edge thanks to members of the Sage team. However, in order for this goal to become a reality, software and hardware must be created in order to support these machine learning algorithms at the edge. There must be a way for a student or programmer to easily access Sage's resources and interact with the Sage environment to run their machine learning algorithms. Because of this problem, the Sage team created an all-encompassing image designed to meet the needs of students and programmers who use the Sage platform. With this image, the Sage team created a customizable, innovative, and user-friendly environment for students and programmers alike to run their world-changing machine learning algorithms with the help of Sage software and hardware. However, having a useful image is one thing, but not every student or programmer has a computer powerful enough to run intensive machine learning algorithms or Sage software plugins. Not only that, Sage has access to some neat pieces of hardware that are available for users to use. So, our next step was to find the best way for users to access hardware to run the Sage image. That's where the Chameleon platform comes in. Chameleon is a testbed of computational resources that are made available for the scientific community for running experiments. Chameleon has hardware available for Sage users at three different locations, two bare metal sites and one virtual machine site. By using the Sage image with the Chameleon hardware, users can have an optimal environment to run their code and experiments. In order to streamline Sage services with Chameleon hardware, the Sage image should include all of Sage's software and services. That's where my work comes in. I worked on creating an image that includes all of Sage's software and services, which is in turn compatible with Chameleon hardware. You can see an overview of Sage's architecture in the image below. Virtual Waggle is one of the services that Sage provides its users and is a feature included into this image. Virtual Waggle is a programming environment where users can build and test edge processing code in an environment that mimics Sage nodes. Users can also use Virtual Waggle to test their machine learning algorithms in an environment that mimics a Waggle node, so they can resolve any potential issues with their code before deploying them onto a Sage node. This image pulls Docker images published and made available on Docker Hub, which is an online repository for software containers. The Chameleon Sage image pulls the most recent version of Virtual Waggle from the Sage repository for use. That way, even if there are any updates made to Virtual Waggle in the future, a user will not be inconvenienced and updates can be rolled out smoothly. In order to streamline the launching of Virtual Waggle, the feature of running and deploying Docker containers without the use of sudo was implemented into this image. More specifically, any Sage service that requires the use of Docker can be run without sudo. Another feature that I spent time on was a prototype deployment method of launching multiple instances of Virtual Waggle in a controlled setting. A use case for this deployment is if a teacher wanted his or her students to have an instance of Virtual Waggle, he or she would just have to run a simple command to launch multiple instances of Virtual Waggle. This command would create n specified instances and pull all the necessary Docker containers from Docker Hub to run Virtual Waggle. I worked on a MicroKate deployment that can accomplish this fact. MicroKates are a lightweight Kubernetes deployment method designed for IoT and edge devices. Though this is just a prototype, it is a feature that Sage will continue to work on and will make possible in the future. Sage Edge plugins is another feature that I included into the Sage image. The Sage Edge plugin repository is helpful for people who wish to create their own plugins to use on the edge. The final feature is access to a local Beehive server. Beehive allows a way for users to push and pull sensor data from devices on the edge. Beehive can also be useful in experiments that require collection of data or training machine learning algorithms. Additionally, using GitHub Actions, I streamlined the process of creating the Chameleon Sage image so feature developers working with or for Sage can spin up a new image by a simple Git push. As a result of the efforts described in this presentation, Three different types of Sage images are now publicly available for Chameleon users. I would like to thank the Sage and the Chameleon team for a wonderful summer. Thank you all for listening.